Vago, leggero, gentile, gentile, gentile.
When I start my career as an opera singer 40 years ago, acting was not so important. The conductor was in command, and the producer mostly told you where to stand, from where to come, and never went deeply into the interpretation. But I always thought acting is equally important. I remember when I first sang Scarpia in a big theater, the conductor shouting to me, "Hey, who you think you are? What are you doing up there? Scarpia is only a policeman." And I believe since this moment started in me a kind of reaction against the old tradition. Maybe because I had so little help for myself, I feel so great sympathy today for the young singers. And I have in Florence every year my opera workshop. So now you will see me at work with some of the students coming from all over the world. First, Wolfgang Lenz, a basso from Germany. We will study La Calunnia, the slander aria from Rossini's Barber Seville. Don Basilio is telling to Don Bartolo how easy it will be to destroy a reputation. A little whisper going everywhere, entering in the ears of everyone. A rumor growing to a dimension of a storm, an explosion, like a cannon. And so the poor victim will be destroyed. Okay, now this chair is for Don Basilio. Wolfgang, will you come and sing La Calunnia? And you know that you come, you move in this direction, call Don Bartolo, and you tell him, "Do you know what is the calunnia?" By the way, how you say calunnia in English?
Slander.
Slander. Okay. And you say, "You know what is the calunnia?" And he will say, "No." Uditemi etatetur. You sit down and you start telling him what is the calunnia. And then suddenly you sit down. It must be a little overacting a little bit because you want to impress him. And the poor man at the end will say, "It will be just frightened to death." Oh, my dear. Because you make a lot of noises, huh? And it must be very gay, very... lot of description, lot of colors, lot of funny inflection in the voice. And so, by the way, it's come back to my memory, a little story. I don't know if I already told you the story of Giulio Neri. Giulio Neri was singing this part in Barber Seville in one seat down to Sicily, just after the war. And I was Figaro, so I was in the out of stage, in the wings, and waiting for my tour to come in. And a little boy with a parananza, what do you call this? And carrying a little small tray with coffee. All right, it was a little child like this. And he came to me, not on stage, outside, behind the stage. Huh? He said, "Where is, dove stavo prevede? Where is the priest?" I said, "The priest? What kind of priest?" "Oh, the tall fellow with a big hat like this." "Oh," I said, "Don Basilio." "Oh, he isn't there." And then I had my own preoccupation. Huh? I had to to clear my voice to be ready to enter. And suddenly, I saw the little boy passing through a wind and in front of the stage, walking all the way through Don Basilio, for Don Basilio. And Don Basilio was like, "Va via, go away. La calunnia, go away. I'm going to tell you, yeah, yeah.
With the big voice of a junior lady, can you imagine? Teacher, hello. Oh, now, right up. Bien qua. And then he called the boy, took the coffee. Left side and Peter. And then he drank the coffee, gave it back. And the boy was I hope that will not happen to you. But anyway, it's a nice story. So let's go from... Lead me to you are on the side, huh? Wait. Don't sit down. And stop from here. Look at me. How can you see me? I know the camera is there, but... La Calunia Sala. And then you go down, and you go up, and you say, Okay, master, please. That means nothing, huh? Don't remember. That is fine, so good, eh? So you say, Agruna, Agruna, come dice prima di come. Insensibile, sottile, cermenta dolcemente.
Thank you.
temporale, oltre molto temporale, molto molto generale, che parale a rembambà, molto molto temporale, molto molto generale, molto molto temporale, che parale a rembambà.
You have to study a little more the characterizations you do here and there. They must be a little more condensed. And there was a little mistake. You came in a little late. Huh?
I
don't slow down. Sometimes you slow down to end one place, keeping tempo. And there are a lot of tradition in this, performing this area, like this calpestato, that you jump on the foot of the poor Don Bartolo. A lot of funny things. I don't agree 100%, but depending where and how you perform this. In a chic theater, you will not do it. Maybe in a small town, you can have more fun, depending on the kind of audience you have. And we must always be ready to do as better as possible, at the best. It's very easy to go back to the old tradition, which are a little heavy to accept today. Okay, that was very good. Thank you very much. So that was Landa. And now with Puccini, we go into jealousy. And that in the church of Sant'Andrea della Valle in Roma, where the very famous singer Tosca, the diva of the time, is visiting her lover Cavaradossi, who is painting. She suddenly recognized in the painting the eyes of her rival, and she makes a scene. It immediately, he convinced her that her eyes are the most beautiful of the whole world. So our Tosca is Manny Meckler from Israel, and her Cavaradossi from Sweden is Josta Lindberg. And Mari, next time I suggest you can, with a less sport dress, it will be more comfortable for you also to perform Tosca. So you are the painter, you know very well that you love her, but you don't care very much about her singing, because when she says stasera canto, she immediately says, ma è spettacolo breve, it's a short song. And now she will see, she will look for the first time your painting, and there is a face that she recognized, La Tavanti, and then the explosion of jealousy. So now we do from here. You are here, and you move. You come closer here, please, because we must be in the frame. And so we imagine that the painting is up there, huh? So, tantra da, chi è quella donna bionda lassù? La Maddalena ti piace, è troppo bella, prezioso loggio. You have to laugh in this prezioso loggio. Why? Because it's the first time she pay a compliment to your painting. Prezioso elogio! Finally, you notice my work, eh? And really, wait. I saw this. Yes, wait. È la Tavanti. Brava! La vedi? So you saw her, you see her. Let's go.
you must, as soon he laughs, it's like he give you this, huh? So he's like, prezioso orologio, really, huh? So he laughs also, again. And imagine that the Maddalena is a little higher, huh? Because if you do a gesture like this, it seems that you indicated him, huh? Very interesting, but... Don't be excited or afraid if you miss a wall, if you change a wall, and if you miss a judgment. We have to improve every time, otherwise no sense. You have to come here to study, not to show that you know everything. I will lose my job. So it's important that the wall you have been missing, eh? But when you sing to her, I saw your eyes all the time a little paralyzed. You were being a little afraid because you knew that some words were not coming back in your memory so easily, eh? But keep alive. Qual occhio al mondo può star di... Eh? Little more in the mask. And also, don't do this little gesture with the finger because, yeah, they're comic. Yeah. They're good for some faster, some brilliant role. And this is not brilliant. Eh? It's the only moment in which you are together happily without the monster of a scat. Yeah? But anyway. Okay, then tomorrow we do something better, huh? Mm-hmm. And bring a long dress, and we will start from the beginning. Huh?
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you. I insist in a long dress because I believe it will help to move and to act properly. And now a lesson in salesmanship. We have here Dr. Malatesta offering a wife to Don Pasquale. The old man can hardly wait to meet his bride. Malatesta makes him believe that she is an angel from heaven, just visiting her. A beautiful rose, sweet, and also very careful in spending money. Of course, the story will have a different ending. What is difficult is to perform this comedy with moderation and elegance in the voice as well as in acting. Our two boys are coming from Chicago, Bruce Schoenmaker and Joseph Garofalo.
Okay, I suggest that change immediately the position of your leg. They are too heroic. You see, if you do like this, I imagine if you have a soul, you're ready to do this. So, like this. She's one. The angelo is in fly on the sky, on the paradise. By accident, she came in the world, in the heart. So, more normal, like sailing, something very important, a beauty. Huh? Put your leg in one side. Both. You can do is you don't necessarily have to move your leg and your hand in rhythm with the music, because you are supposed to anticipate a little bit the action or what is the word. So if you say chioma chioma che vince l'ebano sorriso incantator sorriso incantator. Il ce l'ha fatta nascere per far beato un cor, per far beato un cor. Move a little rapidly, because otherwise the same rhythm in action and in singing make the thing slow. Eh? Start again. It's the importance of the beginning. And the beginning must be more... Bella siccome un angelo in terra pellegrino. And then when you say sorriso incantator, sorriso incantato, little more faces, but not too much, in the right moment. Okay, close.
Che parla e ride
amico incantatore. Sposassi mille, o giubilo ti incanto il petto, il petto, il cuore.
Not too much, not too much.
Okay, it's good, Bruce. You have to try not to, when I said be faster in the action, that doesn't mean that you have to repeat the actions. You did now. What is the word? Bella? Alma innocente ingenua. No. Divide this. Alma innocente ingenua. Okay, and add this, go back, smile, the face, come close to him, very secret, whispering, and then, and then come back this gesture so you can follow my hand with the eyes, with the eyes, and so, and then, this kind, a legato in the action, but more fast, because if you do, bella innocente ingenua, you see, it's slow, huh? Do again the second half. Get close.
Alma innocente ingenua, che se me ne smagnola, modestia impare già.
Okay, that's the first idea, huh? That's the first idea. So you have to move more, to think about what you say when you talk about the flower which opened in the morning. You can make the imitation of this, huh? And you will just look this, imagine this is the flower, huh? Okay, good.
As you see, imagination is the salt of our work. And now by Puccini, persuasion in another style, and here in Florence. 1st September 1299. The rogue Gianni Schicchi refused to examine the will of the dead Boso Donati. But Lauretta, his daughter, in love with a young Donati, knows how to make her father change his mind. We don't need here a deep interpretation, but simplicity and a smile. Michel Truiz comes from New York.
Michel, now Gianni Schicchi, o mio bambino caro, and I will act the part, the role of your father, Gianni Schicchi. Okay. So I'm supposed to shout to the relatives of Don Boso Donati, nothing for them, I don't know, and going out, when I turn, you kneel and you stop me, you block the exit. So, mio bambino, please, I want this and that, huh? Remember, this is not tragic. There is a little moment pathetic, romantic, sentimental, but she is very clever, and she knows she can do everything she wants with the father, just a little twist on the heart of the poor old man. Okay.
Lo dico la gente. Niente, niente, niente.
Now go down.
Oh, mio bambino caro, mi piace bella bella, ma dare un'altra rosa. Oh,
Kind of bad.
Now, it was a little too much in rhythm, huh? It was too much keeping the tempo. You have to give a little more feeling, a little more interpretation. Andrei sul ponte vecchio, ma per buttarmi in alto, mi struggo in tormento, oddio, vorrei morire. So that is the little twist in the heart of old man. Will oblige him to say yes, okay, everything for my daughter. Huh? Okay. You want to do the game?
Yes.
Let's go down.
I showed to my students a film of Verdi's Falstaff in which I play both roles, Ford and Falstaff. I wanted them to realize how important in characterization is the color of the voice. It's a very important thing. You can't perform Rigoletto with the same voice you will use to sing Barbara Seville. You have to change color.